everyone, I'm Aveline. Welcome back to the channel. I hope you're all having an amazing day. So, we are building a mobile home. I almost want to call it a trailer. So, I started building this on stream. When was it? Wednesday? What day is it today? Friday? Okay. I started building this on stream Wednesday, and I asked if chat wanted to see a trailer, or I actually already forgot what the other option was, but they said trailer, so I decided to just build a trailer out of nothing. We just started building a trailer. I will say it was never supposed to be like a super trailer-shaped trailer, if you will, because I also wanted it to be for 8 Sims. So obviously that's a bit difficult to do. Also because I have done this kind of build before, where I basically like made a sort of tiny house, as tiny as they can be, for 8 Sims at least. And then just made their bedrooms like so tiny, so small, that it didn't really feel, it felt more like cupboards with beds in them instead of bedrooms. This was also before we got bunk beds actually. So technically in some of these rooms you could have fit in 4 Sims, I suppose. I just decided to go with 2. But because I just, I wanted to make this for 8 Sims, I also kind of made it like an L-shaped trailer instead, an L-shaped mobile home instead. So I don't know if this is like a classic trailer, but it's supposed to be a mobile home at least. And yes, it's supposed to be for 8 Sims. So we're building this in Evergreen Harbor. I am also gonna turn this a little bit more modern looking for the exterior, using some of the windows from Eco Lifestyle as well as the doors, and we're decorating with some of the wall decor from Eco Lifestyle as well. So it kind of ends up having that sort of vibe to it, that sort of feel to it. But in the end, it's still supposed to be a mobile home. So at least I tried to make it that, but we'll see. Maybe you don't agree with me, but anyway. So 2 things before I start continue talking about the build. There's currently a giveaway running. So if you want any information about the giveaway, you can head on over to my community tab. I do realize that yes, I posted a lot of my videos from the other channel over there, but that's what we do here on YouTube, so you can just ignore them if you're not interested in the other channel. But there is a post, if you scroll up a little, or scroll down, I suppose, a little bit, there's a post explaining how you can join this giveaway. So if you're interested in winning a pack of your choice for The Sims 4, I'd definitely go check it out. And also, I'm streaming tonight over on Twitch, so shortly after this video goes live, I should be live over there, I think. But, or maybe a little bit later. I think this video goes up around 6:30 or maybe a little bit later than that. So I should be streaming at least around 8 p.m. But also you can find updates about that over on Twitter. So just if you want to come hang out, because every time I stream, I swear, I get a new person who says, "Oh, I didn't know you streamed." And I just feel like, well, that means that I haven't mentioned it enough in my videos. So, hey, yes, I stream over on Twitch now. At least I try to consistently do it. I feel like I'm doing okay so far, right? I feel like I'm doing okay. So if you want to come hang out, I don't know what we're building today. No idea. Like I said, I kind of want to be able to remember what the other option was that I gave chat Wednesday, but I don't. So maybe we'll build that one if I remember, but I just can't right now. But anyway, we'll figure it out once I start the stream and everything, and we're just gonna chill and have a good time and build and decorate something in The Sims as per usual. So come hang out if you're interested. And yeah, those were the updates. So about this build, it's built in Evergreen Harbor, like I said before earlier in this video. I think it's built in the quarry, so it's in the upper left map, or the upper left area of the map, I believe, at least. I'm pretty sure I built it up there. On a 30x20, I didn't want to put it on the 20x15, because I just, no, I wanted a little bit more space. We're not utilizing all the space on this lot, though. I did keep a little bit free on both sides of the house, but I just felt like it fit the house better. I know that probably annoys some people, but I don't know, it looks better to me this way, so I'm gonna stick with it. I believe that it's for 2 of each, which makes no sense out of context. I am so sorry, but two parents, 2 teens, 2 kids, and 2 toddlers. And the parents' bedroom, yes, we are using a Murphy bed. I don't think I've touched the Murphy bed since, possibly since Tiny Living came out. So that's like, when was that? January 2020, I think? Yeah, must have been. Yes, most definitely was. So, you know, it's been a while, but it's not my favorite item. However, I was really set on figuring out if I could give them... Actually, did I not end up giving them a living room area in the kitchen as well? Maybe they have two now. Maybe I just completely... See, I'm not mentally wired to use the Murphy bed because technically they have a bedroom in here, but now they... Or they have a living room in here as well as a bedroom, but now they also have a couch and a TV in the kitchen. I don't know. I think both myself and also chat must have forgotten. It's fine. They're a big family, you know, they need a lot of seating spots and they need to be able to watch different things on the TV, so it's fine because there's a lot of different age groups in this house as well, so it's all good. Plus, sometimes maybe you just want to leave the Murphy bed down. I don't know, maybe don't risk getting picked up by the Grim Reaper in The Sims. That is actually the reason why I don't use it, like... That is the reason, because the first house that I built with Tiny Living, I placed down the Murphy bed because it was new and exciting and shiny, so I just wanted to test it out. And I also wanted to play test it because I wanted to see how much space the bed was going to take when it was down instead of being up, you know, hidden, whatever. And my playtester died the first time. She took it down, so she just died. I was like, what the heck? Yeah, I don't know if maybe I'm just unlucky or if that's like a common occurrence when it comes to the Murphy bed, but it kind of put me off of using it, to be honest. So I haven't really touched it much over the past 2 years, but I think I used it a couple of times when Tiny Living was all new, which is a while ago, so yeah, no. But today, for this build, I was convinced by chat to use it, so there you go, there's a Murphy bed in this house, but you can definitely take it out. Like you can see right here, they have another little living room area situation, so it's easy for you to just take the Murphy bed out and put in something else, I suppose. You can just exchange it, swap it out with a double bed and two bedside tables and you're good. But I was convinced to use it, so I did, and then I forgot that I used it, apparently. I don't know how that works, but it's fine. Oh, I forgot to say at the start of the video as well, but I noticed when I was taking the screenshots that there were no potties for the toddlers, so in the uploaded version, that'll be on both Patreon as a tray file, upload, download, whatever. And also the gallery download will come with a potty for the toddlers. It's in the bathroom. It's in the bathroom. I just forgot to place it down while I was decorating, so I did it off cam, but it's there before anybody yells at me. It's there, yes. I really hope that kitchen is fully functional. They do have a mini fridge and also a mini oven and a sink as well, and a, you know, just completely bland counter with no decor on it or whatever. It's been a while since I've done a three tile kitchen, so I hope that it's functional. It should be, technically, if you look at it, like it should be. So I don't fully know if it is, but it should be. It definitely should be. It's not the most luxurious kitchen because, you know, they only have a mini fridge and also a mini oven. They probably have to go shopping so often because they have no room for all that food for 8 Sims in the fridge since it's a mini fridge. But, you know, that's not our problem. The Sims will figure it out. It's okay. Plus, since when did any of the fridges have a limit to how many groceries you can have in them? Right, exactly. But it does feel a little bit odd giving them a 3-tile kitchen considering they are 8 Sims, but it's okay. It's fine. Everything is fine. But also, if you want to keep the Murphy bed, just take out the couch and also the TV and that whole getup. You can delete that completely and place down a 2-tile dining table with 4 chairs so you can actually seat 4 Sims while they're having dinner. That could be an idea. We kind of discussed it on stream, like how are they gonna do this whole eating thing if they're having dinner at the same time. I will say there is I didn't decorate the outside, the exterior, just like the garden area, I suppose. I didn't do that one, or I didn't do that part of the build on stream. I did that after I stopped streaming. Actually, I did it the next day, whatever, it's fine. But they do have a dining table outside and also a grill. So when the weather is nice, they can definitely sit outside, at least like six of them. Or I don't think it's a dining table, I think it's a picnic table. So four of them, but it's fine. There's another four table or four tier table outside too. So technically, if you count outdoor seating spots, they should all be able to sit down at the same time and have dinner. But if you don't, some of them might have to sit on their beds to eat, which I know is a little bit sad, but it's a very small house. So we make do with what we have. I thought it would be better for them to just have bigger bedrooms, to be honest. Because the last time, like I said, it just felt like putting beds in cupboards and or like closets, broom closets, I suppose. So depending on where you're from, whatever you want to call them. But it just felt like a very, very small space to put too many beds in, and I just wasn't feeling that for this build. I wanted them to have proper bedrooms, but that does mean that they don't really have a proper dining setup, so, you know, that's a thing. All in all, it basically depends on how you play the game, because I'm pretty sure some people would be okay with that, but I'm also sure that some people wouldn't. We all play the game differently, and some of us don't even do any gameplay whatsoever and just stick to build, so, you know. Just, you're always welcome to customize the houses to your liking, always. So if there's anything you don't like about the build, just feel free to change it, and, or completely feel free to change it. I'm okay with that, but, this is just kind of what I wanted to do for the build. So, yeah. This whole color scheme was actually based off of, well, it matches the bed swatch now, but it was actually based off of that wall that's on the left side right now, because I found that while I think I was decorating the parents' bedroom, so the bigger living room, if you will, and I thought the swatch was super cute. So I had to use it somewhere, so I ended up placing it in the teens' bedroom, but you can definitely change the color scheme if you don't like it. I ended up finding one of the beds from Dream Home Decorator actually matched it, so I matched the other wall, the other accented wall in there with the other color on the bed sheet. And I don't know, I think it's nice, I think it's cute, but it's definitely a bit on the pink side. So there is that. It's definitely a little bit on the pink side. The toddler's bedroom is super simple, also very pastely. I did change up the swatches of the beds. They were yellow just before, now they're purple, I know, quite confusing. But they don't really have a lot of space in here for anything fun, anything serious, actually, I should say, because they do have a toy box and also a plushie, so I kept the fun things. They just don't really have anywhere to put their clothes or anything like that. So don't think about this build logically, like, where would they have their things in real life? Just disregard that. That's not what this build is about. It's basically about putting as many Sims in as small a place as possible without putting them in closets. Yes. But I'm also not gonna call this a tiny house, because I feel like, I don't even think with all the platforms that I used on the exterior, I don't think it actually even counts as a small home anymore. I think it did before, let me think. I checked it at some point. I don't know if it was before I placed down the roofing, but with this little bit over here, it definitely does not count as a small home anymore. We've talked about this so many times, I really wish that the tile counter did not count exterior tiles, because it really limits what you can do with a build when platform usage on the exterior, so even on roofing, where you wouldn't be decorating because it's a roof, unless you have a rooftop terrace, you know, in that case, that counts. But just plain roofing, I feel like that shouldn't count, and I kind of have this, like, anything like this where you have, it's basically a part of the garden, yard, whatever you want to call it, I feel like that shouldn't count either, because it's not a part of the house itself, it's a part of, you know, what's next to the house, or behind the house in some cases, so I don't know, I just feel like it didn't count, but I don't know how they would fix that. But as for the backyard or side yard or just yard, I don't know what we're gonna go with. But anyway, they have this little sort of almost like an outdoors kitchen, but not entirely. They have a grill area or a barbecue area, whatever you want to call that, with the picnic table. I went with a picnic table. Is that controversial? I'm not really sure, but I went with the one from, or one of the ones from Snowy Escape because it has pillows on it and I like it. So I also felt like, I don't know, it looks structured enough to kind of fit with the house as well. So just ignore if there are any like finishes on it or something that don't really fit the house. I like how it looked with the house, so I went with it. Also, the pillows are definitely plus point for me. And they also have this very, very small pool that I thought would be kind of cute underneath the pergola. I decided to place the pergola down before I actually did the interior of the house, so I wasn't really sure what I would end up placing under the pergola, but I also didn't feel like the outdoors kitchen would fit under there because I wanted it on a platform. And that's a whole different thing with like fences and platforms and then mixing it with half walls. It gets a little bit messy, so I figured it would just be better to keep that little part of the yard completely on the ground instead of placing down a platform there because it would have messed up with the fencing. It's a little wonky sometimes, but playing around with platforms is fun, so you know, we're just gonna overlook it. It's okay. And they also have this little closed off area where I ended up placing down their bicycles. I figured they didn't have a car, and they hopefully go to school somewhere very, very close by, but I don't, you know, we don't know. It's fine. And I just figured with a family this size, they would probably have like a lot of bicycles. They have 5. I know that children can't use bicycles, but there's 2 adults and 2 teens in this house. So maybe one of the adults has 2 bicycles and then they all have, or the remaining have 1 each or something like that. And everyone else gets picked up by a bus or whatever, it's fine. So they just have this little closed off area to make sure that none of the bikes end up getting stolen. Not that we have thieves in The Sims, but you know, just gotta make it a little bit realistic. That was my realistic touch to this build. Yes, not that you can, or not that you can't jump the fence or whatever, just ignore that, just overlook it, it's fine. But as for the rest of the video, I'm just doing some landscaping and some terrain painting, so I will wrap up this voiceover now. If you like this build, you can download it off the gallery. My ID is AvelineYT, and you can also find it under the hashtag Aveline or AvelineYT, and as always, the tray files can be found on my Patreon, which will be linked to in the description box as well as in the pinned comment. And if you like books, if you like BookTube, I do have a channel, so check it out. It is also linked in the description box or through my link tree, as well as in the pinned comment. But that's all I got for you guys today, so I hope you all enjoyed this video. Please like and subscribe and all that good stuff if you did, and I will see you all in the next one. Bye-bye! Let me figure out where the road goes. Even if I'm falling down, I will keep on searching for my highs. You can say I lost my mind, I will keep on holding my head high. Even if the sky is falling down, so high, trusting our wings to fly. Sometimes we're crashing down, but we get up and start from the ground. And I really wanna know, really wanna know, if I'll ever figure out where the road goes. Falling down, I will keep on searching for my highs. You can say I lost my mind, I will keep on holding my head